practice for the Azerbaijan Grand Prix is about to get underway. This is a technical circuit which will nonetheless see some huge speeds with a near flat-out final sector that's twice the length of Shanghai's back straight. Let's see who can find the right balance in their setup today. I'm here with Anthony Davidson once again. Nice to see you, Ant, and I wanted to ask you about how you go about improving the car over the course of a practice session. How much would you say is already known from the pre-race simulations? And how much do you have to do, you know, how much do you have to work on with a real car on a real circuit?
Well, that's a good question, Crofty, and I suppose the simple answer is that there's no such thing as too much information. As you say, the bigger teams have very complex simulations, vast numbers of clever people crunching the numbers back at base. But what they can't tell you is stuff like how the track condition's going to be, or what the temperature's going to be doing over the course of the day, and how all of that's going to be interacting with the tyre. There are so many millions of tiny variables involved in getting these cars around a racetrack quickly, but the computer can't tailor the car to a driver's specific balance requirements. At some point, you still need to put a human being in there and have them feel it through the seat of their pants. And that's why we end up with different drivers having different setups. So what I'm trying to say is, Crofty, nothing beats on-track testing.
Okay, one of the programs we should probably do before qualifying is the qualifying program. Let's prepare ourselves as best we can. We don't want to find ourselves starting at the back. Right, I'll get these changes made. Let's get a few laps under our belt.
Strain on it.
tanks of fuel remaining. Have set us back a little.
Quick look at the classification at the end of the session then. Here are your top three. Bottas, Vettel and Lewis Hamilton. That's it for practice then. We'll see you again soon.
We've had to spend time repairing the damage to the car. Have set us back a little.
Thank you.
is currently in 6th place, P6.
Thank you.
test lap so far is a 147.3.
An interesting practice session there, then. Let's remind ourselves of the top three, who are Hamilton, Vettel, and Valtteri Bottas. Practice times are on the board then, but no points are on offer just yet. We'll be back with more F1 action soon.
We'll be right back.
As all the cars are now over the line, your top three again are Hamilton, a Red Bull, and Valtteri Bottas. That concludes an interesting practice session. Let's hope for more excitement as the weekend unfolds. Baijan, the teams are making their last-minute adjustments before the lights go green, and the fight for pole position can get underway. Now then, Anthony Davidson, you're not getting any younger, but you have been involved in your fair share of qualifying sessions in an illustrious 30-year career. How do you deal with the pressure when you have that one chance to deliver a perfect lap?
It's not so much about dealing with the pressure, it's more about how you approach the risk and just how much of it are you willing to take. You're constantly balancing the car on the edge of grip from braking, cornering and traction. And over the course of a lap, it's easy to get that balance wrong. And that's why achieving the perfect lap is almost impossible. As you say, I've been doing this 30 years now, and it never gets any easier.
We don't need to push too hard in this session. We should have the pace to qualify easily. Thank you. the circuit is clear at the moment, we're good to go. Garage, please. Car ready to leave.
Thank you.
something.
So qualifying is complete and we're all set for an exciting race tomorrow. Your top three are Hamilton, Vettel and Kimi Raikkonen. It's time to leave for now, but we'll be back tomorrow when the Grand Prix itself gets underway.